Good evening, welcome to the Daily Office. I'm Brother Bill, and this is Night Prayer for November the 1st. Today is All Saints' Day. The scripture for this service, Psalm 150, Revelation chapter 21, verse 1 through 4, and 22 through chapter 22, verse 5. Our help is in the name of God the Most High, the Maker of heaven and earth. Let us confess our sins to God. Almighty God, source of all being, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and by what we've left undone. For the sake of our Savior Jesus Christ, forgive us all our offenses. Grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen. And may Almighty God grant us forgiveness of all our sins, and the grace and the comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, come to my assistance, make haste to help me. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit. As in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia, praise God the Most High. Alleluia. Psalm 150. Praise God the Most High. Praise God in the sanctuary. Praise God in the firmament of his power. Praise God for his mighty acts. Praise God according to his excellent greatness. Praise God with the sound of trumpet. Praise God with the psaltery and the harp. Praise God with the timbrel and the dance. Praise God with stringed instruments and organs. Praise God upon the loud cymbals. Praise God upon the high-sounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise God. Praise God the Most High. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. Praise God the Most High. Alleluia. The lesson is from the book of Revelation, chapter 21, beginning at verse 1. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more, and I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them as their God. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away." I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God, the Almighty, and the Lamb. And the city has no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God is its light, and its lamp is the Lamb. And the nations will walk by its light, and the kings of the earth will bring their glory into it. Its gates will never be shut by day. There will be no night there. People will bring into it the glory and the honor of the nations. But nothing unclean will enter it, nor anyone who practices abomination or falsehood, but only those who are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And then the angel showed me the river of the water of life, bright as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb through the middle of the street of the city. And on either side of the river is the tree of life with its 12 kinds of fruit, producing its fruit each month. And the leaves of the trees are for the healing of the nations. Nothing accursed will be found there anymore. But the throne of God and of the Lamb will be in it, and his servants will worship him. They will see his face, and his name will be on their foreheads. And there will be no more night. They will need no light or lamp or sun, for the Lord God will be their light, and they will reign forever and ever. Here ends the lesson. Into your hands I commend my spirit, for you have redeemed me, O God of truth. Keep us as the apple of your eye. Hide us under the shadow of your wings. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. O God, maker and redeemer of all believers, grant to all your faithful departed the unsearchable benefits of the passion of your Son, that on the day of his appearing they may be manifested as your children, through Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, O tender God, you have seduced me, and I was seduced. And the almighty and merciful God, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit, bless us and keep us now and forever. Amen. Alleluia.